In the comparison between Calum Von Moger and Sergio Oliva Jr. and Arnold Schwarzenegger and Sergio Oliva Sr., I'll start with the comparison between the Olivas. The main thing seems to be the three-dimensionality, which is more pronounced in Sergio Sr. versus Jr., and you can see that in the triceps, and that could be the lighting or the posing oil, but if you look at the highlight on Sergio Oliva's tricep, and also on the mid portion of the chest, it just bows out more in the side view, and just cheekbone structure, and just, you know, waist size, and a few other things that makes Sergio Oliva Sr. stand out a little more. Schwarzenegger versus Van Moger, the most obvious thing is skin tone. Schwarzenegger had one of the best skin tones in bodybuilding. If you want to include vein structure, where it's less sloppy, more sloppy on Van Moger, less sloppy on Schwarzenegger, more refined striations on the chest, just a better tone. It makes a big, giant difference how your skin's wrapped around your musculature. But another thing is you can just see in the morphing back and forth of Schwarzenegger's to Van Moger's face that Van Moger is kind of doing an impression of Schwarzenegger where he's, you know, pounding his lip out more. And I mean, if you look at halfway through the transition, kind of looks more like Schwarzenegger than Schwarzenegger does, just the caricature of the morphing between the two. But overwhelmingly, what separates Schwarzenegger from Sergio Oliva and from everybody else practically on the planet is Schwarzenegger's bicep peak. I mean, it's just, if he didn't have that, he would be, I mean, lost in comparison to where he is in history. I mean, just lost if he didn't have that one body. But not that the skin tone, the chest development, the calf development, the full quads, et cetera, didn't add and plus he had a structured face, which goes a long way in movies and even in bodybuilding, whether you want to admit it or not. I mean, you can see it going back and forth through the morph. Van Moger doesn't stand out necessarily more than Schwarzenegger or vice versa in tricep or forearm or shoulder, etc., for size, but bicep, I mean, come on. I mean, this is just ridiculous. However Schwarzenegger got that, maybe physical therapists will be able to find a way to stretch your ligaments or allow people to get more out of a bicep curl, just like Schwarzenegger got. Maybe there's things impeding where you just have this roll thing, so to speak, or something along those lines, and all of a sudden you can gain more out of your bicep than you could. But whatever it would take for somebody like Van Moger to all of a sudden have that bowing out of the bicep, that warping where it just bends outward, and that would make so much of a difference, but he doesn't have it, even though he comes 40 years later. And you'd expect a bodybuilder that looks like Schwarzenegger to have that key body part. But I think getting that might be feasible in the future, but it's beyond just doing the same old training. I mean, of course, you could find what affects your bicep more through training, but I think that a functional physical therapy a la Gary Gray, G-R-A-Y, that the field would concentrate on that type of thing more, where you would structure yourself to be affected by training differently, as opposed to it's mostly about injuries, which is obviously a noble cause and you want to get over those. A person could probably go outside their given genetics through epigenetics by changing their leverage, and that certainly is a factor in Arnold Schwarzenegger's development. He's just doing bicep movements, getting a hell of a lot more out of the motion than Oliva Sr., Jr., Calum Von Moger, and practically everybody else on the planet.